segues off of that because that powerful, beautiful image of a police force that looks like New York City and serves with compassion and connection to our neighborhoods. This whole neighborhood policing vision is policing of and by and for the people. The kind of policing that will work more and more, that will make us safer, but also create harmony and heal the wounds of the past. That's an example of what we now have to do for our nation. Sometimes I say our nation is in an identity crisis. We're trying to figure out who we are. We had an election. It wasn't necessarily our finest hour in terms of the public discourse. It wasn't the most conclusive, ironically, because of the skew between the Electoral College and the popular vote. But really, it gets to the work at hand. We're in an identity crisis because we're trying to sort out who we are and what we believe in as a nation. It's unresolved on so many levels. I don't doubt where it's going. I believe we are on a pathway towards inclusivity and mutual respect. But it won't happen overnight. It won't be easy. There'll be setbacks before we reach some of those goals. But what is New York City's role in the midst of this? Well, New York City has an advantage. We already know who we are. We're not having an identity crisis. We already stand for an inclusive, multi-faith, multicultural society.